That's someone's door. Ah, there he is.
Huh?
This is worse than being late for your wedding, the birth of your son, and your own funeral all at once.
What?
Jeez, to show up now like it's no big deal. You made us stay up all night while you slept like a baby in your bed? Just like Hina said, everyone was there, besides Kyoko. And then I noticed. They'd formed a circle around something. As soon as I saw what that something was... What the? Before I could catch myself, I cried out. Spread out in front of them were the remains of Monokuma.
What are you doing?
What does it look like? We're dismantling it to see what makes it tick.
So it's a robot.
Dismantling?
I mean, I knew that, but I wonder how they found that out.
But I mean, that's Monokuma you're messing with, right?
Yeah, that's right.
She's not even phased.
Relax, there's no danger. You say that, but... What is this? What are you guys doing? It looks like it's been professionally dismantled. How is that possible? Tearing apart something like that isn't dangerous? Seriously, what are you thinking? How can you say tearing apart something like that isn't dangerous? Idiot, if you hadn't been sleeping in, you'd already know what's going on.
Hey,
well, I guess
on.
I'll handle this. I'll explain what's going on, Makoto, because that's how much I like you.
Hmm.
Yakuya found this little fella laying around, then we tore it apart. That doesn't explain anything.
What?
Just before we went to bed last night, I came to the gym to try and talk to Monokuma. I wanted to see if he had any new information about Kyoko's disappearance. And I found him here, just like normal. However, when I found him, he was no more than a regular toy. He didn't react, didn't say a word. You're saying he wasn't moving at all?
Hmm.
I waited there until nighttime officially began, but still Monokuma laid there motionless. I gathered everyone up as quickly as possible so they could take a look. Even then, he still didn't make a move. So I immediately initiated the disassembly process. It was master stroke of genius, a chance to find out what made Monokuma tick. One thing we discovered is that he's quite a sophisticated machine. It's leagues beyond any normal remote control toy. Who has enough free time to invest in something like that anyway? But besides that, what I'm wondering is why did he stop moving all of a sudden?
Hmm.
I thought maybe he'd malfunctioned, but we didn't find any cause as we were taking him apart. So if he didn't break down, then maybe something happened to his puppeteer, the mastermind. Something unexpected. I can't imagine any other possibility. Something unexpected. They were probably so scared of Master they ran away in terror. Or maybe they got sick or something? But Monokuma made his announcement this morning, right? Who was that if not the mastermind? Oh, I'm sure that's a recording. It's set to a timer and plays as necessary. That's true. He says the exact same thing every day, right?
Hey
guys, I don't think now's a good time for light conversation.
You know?
I just found something. What is it? It's...
Huh?
It's what? A bomb. There's one installed in every Monokuma robot, I'm sure.
What?
A bomb? That's super bad. We need to get rid of it. Roger that. It appears the bomb is a motion sensor. Any sudden movements, it's sure to go off. Motion sensor? For serious? Ugh, I'm starting to get all shaky.
Just a second!
Hey, get it together. You're a man, aren't you?
Yeah.
I'm fine. I'm totally fine. You're so not fine. You're all, Oh, I probably should have mentioned, the motion sensor is off right now. Jeez, don't scare me like that. God, you're like the world's most spineless worm of the century.
Don't be mean!
Hey, come on, the century's just getting started. Don't call the race already. Okay, then. Whatever, just hurry up and put the bomb down. Hanging on to it's not gonna do any good. Oh yeah, good call.
Well?
Okay, it's down. Everything's all good. Hiro put the bomb down, but that wasn't my main concern at that point. My eyes were glued to Monokuma's remains. He just stopped moving all of a sudden. Was it really because something had happened to the mastermind that they weren't expecting? But what could that have been? When I thought about it, I couldn't help but think back to the night before, being attacked by that masked figure.
Just a second.
Hey, Makoto? Huh?
Hey.
Don't ha us. Did you hear anything we just said? Huh? So that's a no. What are you, some kind of brain-dead farm animal? Sorry. We were saying, since we're done dismantling Monokuma, what should we do now? And we've decided to continue our offensive assault.
It's all clear.
To try and uncover the mastermind's true identity, we're going to break into the headmaster's room. Really?
Naturally.
Since the mastermind appears to have stopped all activity, now's our chance, wouldn't you agree? But if the mastermind comes back while we're in there...
What?
If you're scared, you're welcome to stay here by yourself. Or go live in the chicken coop with all the other chickens. You can be chicken number 6.
Such ignorance.
This is a battle, a fight to the death between us and the mastermind. We don't have time to deliberate.
But...
Yeah, I mean, I don't want to have to kill each other or anyone else, but we have a chance now.
Come on.
So, what are you going to do? Are you going to run away or are you going to fight? You're right. I'll go with you.
It's all clear.
Okay then, we're going to break into the headmaster's room. Everything comes down to this moment. Anything can happen, so prepare yourselves. I'll follow you anywhere, master, to all the ends of the earth. Sakura, if you can hear me, lend me your strength.
How about that?
I can do this. I'm a man, and I can do this. I've got the will of the entire universe on my side. We each found determination in our own ways, and when we were ready, we left the gym. Our target was the headmaster's room on the fourth floor of the school.